Hey, friend! Last time we learned about teen numbers. We learned how to identify them by counting sets and practice how to write them. When we write numerals like this, we are representing or showing numbers. There are many more ways we can represent or show numbers. Let me show you how. Just like I said, when we write numerals like these, we are representing or showing numbers. Can you think of any other ways we have represented numbers? Good thinking! We have used pictures to represent numbers. We can use pictures like this to represent numbers. We can even use 10 frames to help us organize our pictures. That's better. Now it is easier to count this picture because we can count on from 10. 10, 11, 12. We can even find new ways to represent numbers. Look at this new math tool. These are called base 10 blocks. We are going to use two kinds of base 10 blocks. We call this a 1 because it's just one block. And this long block here is called a 10 because it's made up of 10 ones. So how do we use these 10 and 1 blocks to represent numbers? Let's find out. So far, we have used numerals, pictures, and 10 frames to represent the number 12. Do any of these representations show how 12 can be grouped into a set of 10? Yes! The 10 frames organize 12 into one group of 10 with 2 left over. Let's think about our base 10 blocks. If 12 objects fill up one 10 frame with 2 objects left over, how many 10 blocks will we need? 1! This 10 block is the same as showing one full 10 frame, but we're not done! How many objects were left over in our 10 frames? 2! So we'll need 2 1 blocks. Now our base 10 blocks match what is shown in our 10 frames. Awesome! As we find more ways to represent numbers, the number 10 keeps coming up. 10 is a very important number in math. In fact, we are going to use the number to represent the number 12 one more way. Take a look at our base 10 blocks. We have one 10 block and 2 1 blocks that show or represent the number 12. If we put this 10 and these 2 ones together, it makes 12. Can you think of something we can do to add together this 10 and these ones? Good thinking! We can write an addition sentence. If we add this 10 plus these 2 ones, we get 12. We can use numerals to write a number sentence to match. 10 plus 2 equals 12. Great job, friend! We were able to represent the number 12 5 different ways. We used numerals, a picture, 10 frames, base 10 blocks, and an addition sentence. Whew! When I look at these representations of 12, I keep seeing the numbers 1 and 2. Here in the numeral, we use 1 and 2 to write the number 12. And here in the 10 frame, we have 1 10 and 2 left over. Then we have 1 10 and 2 ones for our base 10 blocks. And then again, we have 1 10 here and 2 here in our addition sentence. It's not magic, it's math. Let's take a look at another number. Here is the numeral we use to show the number 16. It is made up of a 1 and a 6. If we wanted to represent 16 with base 10 blocks, how many 10 and 1 blocks do you think we would use? We would use 1 10 and 6 ones, just like the numbers we used in the numeral 16. That means our addition sentence would be 10 plus 6 equals 16. There's that 1 and 6 again. Finally, let's take this picture representing 16 and put it inside these two 10 frames. Exactly like I suspected. We have 1 10 and 6 left over. Wow, friend, you did such a great job today. Not only did we practice representing teen numbers 5 different ways, you also learned how to use a new math tool, base 10 blocks. Remember, in math, we can solve any problem together. You can count on it. See you next time. Hey, hey.